Throughout my life, I have been asked, how am I confident without makeup, adding heat to my hair, or using tons of products on my skin? Those are the tips that I am going to share with you today. How to be naturally confident. I'm going to be 21 this year, and tons of people around me either wear makeup because they really do love it, they look at it as an art form. But unfortunately, there's also a handful of people that wear makeup because they're not confident in their natural skin, or they add a lot of heat and products to their hair and their skin just because they don't think their natural beauty can be emphasized without it. I think that there are a few tips which can really help you to try and build your self-esteem up and take care of things from within. So the first set of tips is dealing with something that personally I look at first when I see a person, and that is their teeth. So the first thing is to floss every second day. I know it sounds like I'm your mother telling you to floss, but I swear in the last 3 or 4 years is where I really got into flossing and doing it at least every second day. And if I can't, then at least twice a week. It helps you to make sure that you obviously don't have food stuck in your teeth and prevents any cavities from taking place in which you would need to get fillings and things like that. The second thing is to get a really good toothpaste. I don't mean getting a whitening toothpaste. Personally, for me, I've seen that whitening toothpaste actually either make your teeth look very unnatural, or they make your teeth very, very sensitive. Also, swapping out your toothbrush every 6 months is a big thing, because many people that I know of actually don't do that. They don't realize that eventually it's actually a lot of bacteria, and the actual hardness of the bristles would help to take out whatever stains, whatever on your teeth, actually wear away after the first 6 months. The next thing is also to obviously not have too much of caffeine. I personally hate coffee, so I guess that works to my advantage. But if you are someone that likes to have caffeine, try and cut down on the amount that you have, or try alternatives such as matcha, rooibos tea, or any kind of black tea in that sense. Now, the reason that I do say to stop caffeine is because tons of you already know caffeine does stain your teeth. Along with that is to not smoke and drink too much of alcohol, because that also causes one bad breath, and two, it stains your teeth, and it's really, really hard after gaining those habits to rectify it. Personally, I have been using Kind Brushes products for my oral hygiene care. I love their products. It's a South African-based brand, and it's highly sustainable. And I actually got you guys a promo code that is linked down below. And I would highly recommend, one, supporting your local businesses, and two, looking at more sustainable sources for your oral hygiene, such as from Kind Brush. Many girls place a lot of beauty onto their hair. Obviously, that is changing with society nowadays, and I personally don't believe beauty standards should be set on anything exterior, but unfortunately that's the society that we live in, and tons of people either just don't like that their hair is frizzy, or that it's thick, or that it's too thin, or that it's too wavy, or that it's pin straight. And if you add too many heat and products to your hair, one, when you get older, like let's say your 40s or 50s, you can start balding very, very easily. Number two, your hair can start falling out even now if you use too many products. Three, your hair becomes extremely dead and dry, and you can lose the natural beauty of your hair once you add too many products and heat to it. So the first thing is to invest in a really good shampoo and conditioner. So I just have the Oh So Heavenly Cocoa Butter Vegan Shampoo, which I've actually been using. It's a really good shampoo and makes your hair smell amazing and really, really soft. The other thing that I use is coconut oil. It's a very Indian thing to say, and I said it again in my hair and skin routine video, which I did a few months back. Usually I do it before I wash my hair the next day so that the oils get into my hair. This prevents dryness, promotes thickness in your hair, and it also helps with dandruff if you do suffer with that. And that's why my hair is still quite thick even to this day. Along with that is to let your hair... The next thing is to let your hair air dry, and try to not always blow dry it and straighten it every second that you get, because again, the heat tools really does make your hair get a lot of split ends, makes it quite coarse, and it can make you lose a lot of hair. And the other thing is to trim your hair every 6 months or so. I would probably just like trim off like that much every 6 months. I think you guys can see it there. And it just, one, helps your hair actually grow faster. I know it sounds counterintuitive, but it makes your hair grow faster, and it makes your hair a lot more healthy and not have prolonged strands of split ends on your hair. So rather nip it at the bud, as the saying goes. The final set of tips is probably what you all clicked on this video for, and that is for all the tips pertaining to your skin. So the first tip is to sleep for at least more than 8 hours every single night. I know tons of you are probably rolling your eyes at me and are like, what about school? What about stress? What about binging your favorite TV? Soapy. I honestly had a very big problem sleeping for at least 8 hours, especially with university. But it's important to prioritize your sleep. Obviously, just getting sleep in general is really good for your whole body because your body obviously needs to rest and rejuvenate from the day's work. But sleep really does reduce your under eye circles. I've seen this from myself. At the end of last year, when it was exam time to hand in all the projects, essays, go and write exams, and I was studying quite a lot. If you guys go to probably any of my previous videos, you guys will see I had quite dark circles under my eyes. Sometimes that is genetic, but for me, I know that it was definitely due to a lack of sleep. And so once I started making sure I get at least 8 to 10 hours of sleep, now that it is the times that we live in and we have the ability to go to sleep whenever we want and get up whenever we want, I make sure that I get 8 to 10 hours of sleep, and I've seen the biggest difference both in just the glow off my skin as well as the underneath circles of my eyes. The next thing is to obviously invest in very good skincare products and sunscreen. Sunscreen, a lot of people think, oh, you just want to put sunscreen, you don't want to burn your skin, or you only need to put it when you go outside. But if you have a room in your house that has windows, you are being exposed to the light. It might not be direct, but there's still that UV rays that is coming in, and it is going to reach your skin. And it's not just for sunburns. The sun rays, unfortunately, causes our skin and our cells to actually metabolize faster, and that causes us to age faster. And unfortunately, the fairer your skin is, the more quicker you will age, just because you don't have any melanin to kind of combat the sun's rays. But if you use sunscreen on a daily basis, I use it every single morning with my skincare products. I just use African Rooibos skincare product, which you guys have heard before. But my skincare is extremely, extremely important to me, especially in the last few years of my life, when I really did start, one, doing research about it, two, finding what works for my skin, but three, making sure that it doesn't break my budget or my bank either. If you use sunscreen from the get-go, then your aging won't be as bad when you get older, and you won't have to invest in so many anti-aging products in the first place. With skincare, I obviously include lip care. It doesn't have to be anything too big. It can literally be like a really well-made lip ice or lip balm from any kind of pharmacy, or anything that you guys see like Clicks, Dischem. But for all of the people there that are of color, personally, I've seen that products with any kind of petroleum jelly in it tends to darken my lips. It kind of works as how any tanning oil goes on. So I tend to only use Vaseline in the winter and when I'm inside, and in the night only. Everybody looks at your teeth and your lips when you are talking, so taking care of your lips and taking care of your teeth, as I said before, are really important. The next thing is to have a balanced diet, have tons of water, and obviously exercise. It's very overly said, but it's very underdone, and it really does work. I'm not saying go to the gym for 50 hours a day. Even yoga is extremely good for rejuvenation of your cells and getting your blood flowing. And just getting your blood flowing in general helps with delivering oxygen to your cells, and it helps to, again, just rejuvenate your facial cells and not make it look, one, dull, two, it helps with anti-aging as well. With the healthy eating, you guys will see that if tons of people eat overly processed foods or overly fried foods or anything like that, I actually did a paper about this last year, the more energy your body will need to process, that causes a lot of oxygen radiation in your body, and that can kind of cause you to age quite a lot. That's why areas that tend to eat more faster foods tend to look older than their actual age. It's really bad for your skin, just because the excess oils can cause you to flare up if you have any skin conditions. I drank about 2 liters to 3 liters of water a day, and I swapped out soda almost completely with having lemon in my water. Helps with, again, metabolization, and water also just really helps to rehydrate your skin and prevent any dryness and flakiness both of your scalp and your skin, your lips, etc. The next thing is to please do not pick at any of your scars or anything like that that might come on your face from any acne, rashes, or anything like that. I know it's very tempting to do that, but it just causes darker blemishes and things like that. Rather suffer for 2 or 3 days and then have the scar fall off by itself rather than continuously picking at it and having a longer term to wait before the scar actually heals and the darkening goes away. Disclaimer before I say this tip, body hair is all up to you how you want to use it. If you want to let it grow out, you don't want to take out anything, then obviously do you, whatever suits you. I just get everything either threaded or waxed. I wax my upper lip because I have very sensitive upper lip, so I cannot even get through threading here before like tears start rolling down my face. But for your eyebrows especially, it's extremely, extremely important to get that done as that frames your face. And so I just have gotten mine threaded from the time that I was 16. And I just feel that one, threading prevents any skin pulling, which can cause wrinkling in your older age. And it also helps with the better shape of your eyebrows rather than waxing. It's more precise. It also prevents any thick hair growth and darkening of the skin like waxing does or using hair removal cream. So I really hope that you all found this quite useful and that it helps you become more confident without having to rely on any external sources. Obviously, if you love doing your hair and your makeup, then obviously do that. I'm not here to judge or say that it's horrible if you do that. But I know there's tons and tons of people out there who aren't confident in their skin because either they have acne or they have blemishes or things like that, or they hate their natural hair just because it's frizzy and not what society deems beautiful. And this applies to both men and women. You don't need to rely on your hair or your skin or your teeth or the color of your eyes or what clothes you wear to say that you're beautiful. But I know it's easier said than done, and that's why I'm giving these tips, because this is what personally helped me. And yeah, just a disclaimer, I'm not in any way bashing anyone that does do the things that I said I don't do in the beginning. That's just my choice. The same way it's your choice if you have hair or not, or whether you wax or shave, or whether you leave everything, or whether you wear any makeup or you don't. It's all up to you. These are just the tips that obviously if you want, they can apply to you. I really hope that you guys enjoyed this video. Please let me know if this helps you in any way down below, or if there's any other tips that you would love to share. And I hope that you guys have a wonderful week filled with lots of love, happiness, light, positivity, and increased confidence. Love you guys. Bye.